Meghan Markle and Prince Harry announced earlier this month they are expecting their first child, but why is Meghan more likely to have twins? On Monday, October 15, Kensington Palace released a statement confirming Meghan and Prince Harry are expecting their first child. The announcement came as the Duke and Duchess of Sussex touched down in Australia to begin a 16-day tour of Oceania. Kensington Palace tweeted, "Their Royal Highnesses the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are very pleased to announce that the Duchess of Sussex is expecting a baby in the spring of 2019. The news came just 5 months after the pair married in a lavish ceremony at Windsor Castle in May, watched by millions worldwide." Kensington Palace added, "Their Royal Highnesses have appreciated all of the support they have received from people around the world since their wedding in May and are delighted to be able to share this happy news with the public. All eyes have been on Meghan's growing baby bump as she visited Australia, New Zealand, Tonga and Fiji with her husband. Bookmakers have also been paying close attention, with some slashing odds on the Duchess being pregnant with twins. Coral reduced its odds from 8-1 to 4-1, while Paddy Power slashed theirs from 33-1 to 12-1. The reason for the speculation around Meghan's pregnancy being twins is her age. At 37 years old, the Duchess' pregnancy is labeled a geriatric pregnancy. Women who fall pregnant over the age of 35 are considered to be having a geriatric pregnancy. It is this category that makes Meghan more likely to be carrying twins, as according to the NHS, the chances of having unidentical twins are a lot higher during geriatric pregnancies. Women over 35 are more likely than their younger counterparts to release more than one egg during ovulation. As women age, hormones alter, causing more than one egg to be released. Head of Family and Professional Support at the Twins and Multiple Births Association, Helen Turner, told Express.co.uk, "Older women, so women in their late 30s, early 40s, are more likely to hyperovulate. As far as we understand, it's due to changing levels of hormones." Despite the bookies slashing odds on Meghan having twins, according to NHS Choices, women over 40 years old are most likely to have multiple pregnancies. The chance of a multiple pregnancy is also increased when babies are conceived through IVF. Meghan may also be subject to more health checks throughout her pregnancy, as geriatric pregnancies are also associated with risks of high blood pressure and gestational diabetes. It seems that the relationship between Meghan and the Queen is growing extremely fast, and by the looks of it, she is becoming the Queen's favorite royal wife. Here are 12 signs that show how Meghan is quickly winning the hearts of not only the public but also the royal family. Meghan Markle has quickly adapted from being a Hollywood B-lister actress to the life of a royal. Now she gets to wear fancy hats and pantyhose and make meaningless small talk with posh people from all over the world. She has nailed almost every appearance she has had, be it for a royal engagement or some holiday or event. And this is due to one reason. She has the Queen herself overseeing all the critical aspects of the Duchess of Sussex's training to prepare her for royal life, and has made sure that her daughter-in-law has only the most trusted staffers to give her counsel and some more freedom when it comes to some previously unbreakable royal rules. With all the queenly attention, the granting of special favors and the bestowing of some pretty amazing gifts, we beg to wonder, is Meghan Markle the Queen's new favorite royal wife? We have made a list of 12 signs that might indicate that the Duchess of Sussex is rising to be one of the top ladies when it comes to Buckingham Palace. Meghan and the Queen have already spent quality time together, in the form of a visit to Chester, which was also the Duchess's first ever solo engagement. The town is located around 200 miles northwest of Kensington Palace. The Duchess and the Queen unveiled the Mersey Gateway Bridge at Catalyst Science Discovery Centre in Widnes and opened the Story House Theatre. This was quite the surprise, as Kate Middleton, Duchess of Cambridge, had to wait a full year of being part of the royal family before the Queen invited her to accompany her without Prince William on an official appearance. "They are fast-tracking Meghan, there is no doubt about it," said my royal source. The Queen has seen how well Meghan has been doing connecting with people on walkabouts and is quite confident about her being an asset to the family. Ever since she joined the royal family, Meghan hasn't changed one bit. She still is the outspoken activist with no one telling her what to or not to say. The About the Duchess of Sussex page chronicles every part of Meghan's pre-royal life, such as her career and her activism. Nothing about Meghan's introduction to the public as an official member of the firm is an accident or afterthought. Everything is carefully checked and nothing is written without getting the approval of the Queen first. From the very start, it seemed that the Queen heavily favored Prince Harry's fiancée, as she broke a tradition that was held for decades. That was when she invited Meghan to join the royal family at Sandringham for their annual Christmas celebration. She was the first ever non-spouse to be invited to spend the family on the estate with the royal family. However, it wasn't that easy for Meghan, as she reportedly had to go through multiple wardrobe changes and a somewhat fraught Christmas luncheon with the entire family where Princess Michael wore what many considered to be a racist brooch with flying colors. The soon-to-be Duchess impressed the hard-nut-to-crack Prince Philip with her knowledge of his family's history, which she reportedly learned from Ancestry.com. With that, she also impressed the Queen. During the Queen's televised Christmas address, some eagle-eyed fans spotted a never-before-seen photograph of Meghan and Harry standing on a table in Her Majesty's sitting room. There was no photo of the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, even though there were some shots of her great-grandchildren Prince George and Princess Charlotte. Anyone who has gone to their grandmother's house at the holiday knows what that means. Seriously, what does it mean? I have no idea. A palace insider has revealed that the Queen wanted Meghan and Harry to have the wedding of their dreams, adding, she saw how happy her grandson was and she was impressed by Meghan's interest in royal wedding traditions. While there were rumors of large rows over the invitation list to William and Kate's wedding, the Queen reportedly did not impose any rules on Harry and Meghan. They wanted a much more intimate, personal wedding and the Queen understood. We don't know what she thought of the Reverend Michael Curry, even though several other royals made their feelings known with plenty of eye-rolling and laughter. Prince Harry has revealed that Meghan even charmed the Queen's notoriously yappy corgis, the very minute she set foot in Buckingham Palace to meet his grandmother. I've been getting barked at for 34 years and she comes in, and nothing. Both women are known to be avid dog lovers, and that has surely helped Meghan bond with the Queen. A few months before the wedding, unfortunately, the Queen's last corgi passed away, rest in peace in dog heaven, and she said that she wasn't getting a new one. This might be because of the fact that the Queen has also been spending quality time with Meghan's rescued dog, her beagle, Gay. The lucky dog has been seen traveling with the Queen in her Range Rover through the streets of Windsor the day before the wedding. It seems that Meghan will have no need to look for a dog sitter, as the Queen seems to be willing and the perfect fit for the role. Meghan Markle and Queen were all smiles when they appeared together in Cheshire less than a month after the suit's star's marriage to Prince Harry. Queen Elizabeth and the Duchess of Sussex appeared as thick as thieves, giggling and chatting as they made their first joint appearance. But behind the scenes, it's now claimed there was tension between the pair when Meghan didn't obey one of the Queen's stipulations for the engagement. In forthcoming biography Charles at 70, Thoughts, Hopes and Dreams, author Robert Jobson writes that Meghan and Queen Elizabeth's first engagement got off to a shaky start. In an excerpt published by the Daily Mail, Jobson claims that prior to the event Meghan disregarded instructions from the Queen's aides that the 92-year-old monarch would be wearing a hat. According to Jobson, the Duchess of Sussex didn't know this meant she was also expected to wear a hat, leaving the Queen a little baffled when Meghan showed up without one. I don't think the Duchess fully understood, a senior figure close to the monarch told Jobson. This was not a request. They are for others to make, not the Queen. Jobson added that Meghan's lack of respect for the monarch's rules had been duly noted by the Queen's staff. Despite this, the pair are still said to be close, with their relationship cemented in part by their shared love of dogs. A miscommunication over hats wasn't the only slip-up to occur during Meghan's first engagement with the Queen. A video posted to Twitter by UK radio station LBC shows a flustered Meghan looking confused over whether she should get into the car first. Meghan can be seen asking what the Queen prefers, before quickly cutting in front of her grandmother-in-law to get in first. While royal protocol dictates that Meghan must walk behind the Queen, the Duchess of Sussex appeared unaware that it is the elder royal's preference to always sit behind the driver's seat, hence the mix-up.